Hi, this is Asin. You are now watching Asin Math TV. In this video, we will learn how to solve the system of equations by matrix method. We can first convert the equation into matrix form. So we are going to copy all the coefficients in one matrix. So we have 3, minus 2, 3, 2, 1, minus 1, 4, minus 3, 2. And all the unknowns in one matrix, so x, y, z, and the right hand side of the equation exactly the same, 8, 1, 4. We can let A be equal to the coefficients matrix, so we have 3, 2, 4, minus 2, 1, minus 3, 3, minus 1, 2. And I'm going to first obtain the transpose. Transpose means that we convert row to column. So we have 3 minus 2, 3, and column to row. So 3, 2, 4. Minus 2, 1, 3, minus 3. So minus 2, 1, minus 3. 3 minus 1, 2. So we have 3 minus 1, 2. Next is to determine the adjoint of the matrix A. To determine the adjoint of the matrix A, which means that we have to determine the cofactor of each M3. To determine the cofactor of the M3, 1, 1, row 1, column 1, so we are going to hide the row 1 and hide the column 1, and we left only 4 entries, which are 1, negative 3, negative 1, 2. Then next, we have the second entry, so we hide the first row and the second column, and we left minus 2, minus 3, 3, 2. And for the first row, the column, we left minus 2, 3, 1, negative 1. And second row, first column, so 2, minus 1, 4, 2. And we continue in the same process. So we have hide, hide, so 3, 3, 4, 2. Hide, hide, so 3, 2, 3, minus 1. And we have 2, 1, 4, minus 3. Hide and hide, so 3, minus 2, 4, minus 3. And the last one, 3 minus 2, 2, 1. So what we are going to do here is, remember, for the cofactor of each M3, the sign should be alternately plus, minus, plus. So we should have plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. So which means that what we have here is, just have to determine the determinant of this 2x2 matrix. So we have A times D minus B times C. So which means that we have 1 times 2 minus negative 3 times negative 1. And we obtain negative 1. Negative, positive, negative. So we have minus 1. And next we have negative 2 times 2 minus negative 3 times 3. So we obtain 5. Positive, negative, negative. So minus 5. And next we have negative 2 times negative 1 minus 1 times 3. So we have minus 1. Next, 2 times 2 minus 4 times negative 1. So we obtain 8 with negative. So negative 8. Then next, 3 times 2 minus 4 times 3, which is minus 6. Next, we have 3 times negative 1 minus 2 times 3, which is minus 9 minus plus 2 times minus 3 minus 4 times 1. So we have minus 10. And we have 3 times minus 3 minus 4 times negative 2. So we have minus minus plus. So plus 1. And the last M3, we have 3 times 1 minus 2 times negative 2. And we obtain positive 7. Next, we are going to obtain the determinant of the matrix A. So which means that we just have to copy the first row, all the entries in the first row of the transpose matrix. So which means that we have 3, 2, 4. And we copy the first row of the adjoint matrix. So we have negative 1, negative 5, and negative 1. Then we plus together. So we should have 3 times negative 1 plus 2 times negative 5 plus 4 times negative 1. So we obtain minus 17. So the inverse matrix is equal to 1 over the determinant, can be written in this form, times the adjoint matrix A. So which means that x, y, and z are equal to inverse matrix . So we just have to transfer here. Times the right-hand matrix of the equation. So which means that we have to bear in mind that when we perform matrix multiplication, always take the row of the first matrix times the column of the second matrix. When we times, make sure the matrix match, the entry of each matrix match. The position is very important. So first one times with first one. So we have minus 1 times with 8, and we plus second with second. So minus 5 times 1 plus minus 1 times 4. So we obtain negative 17. And we have to times 1 over negative 17, which means that we just have to divide negative 17, and we obtain positive 1. So x is positive 1. And next, so we go to the second row. So minus 8 times first entry with first entry. Then we plus minus 6 times 1 plus 9 times 4. So we obtain negative 34 divided by negative 17, and we obtain positive 2. Then for z, we have negative 10 first one with first one, so times 8 plus 1 times 1 second with second and third with third, so 7 times 4. So we obtain negative 51 divided by negative 17, and we obtain 3. So which means that x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, and z is equal to 3. If let's say we want to check our solution, we can make use of the calculator as well. So we go to the equation function. What we want here is the multilinear equation, and we want to have 3 unknowns, and we just have to input accordingly. So we have 3 minus 2, 3, 8. Second equation, 2 minus positive 1, negative 1, 1. And the last equation, 4 minus 3, 2 and 4. So we obtain x is 1 correct, y is 2 correct, and z is 3 correct, which means that our solution are correct. Okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.